Hello students, welcome to video classes. So according to schedule, today's topic is oscillations. Okay, let us solve the problems based on the oscillations. So before going to this video, I'm going to send you the assignment of the PDF file. Okay, you can go through the problems. Okay, right now we are going to solve some of the important problems from assignment of oscillations chapter. Okay, let's go for the problems. Hello students, so the problem is saying that at a particular point the velocity of the particle is given, it is the root 3 by 2 times to the maximum velocity, and the amplitude is given A. So that means the velocity of that particular point is equals to root 3 by 2 times to the maximum velocity. So because in the problem is saying the mean position means the velocity will be maximum and the acceleration will be minimum. So velocity is maximum at mean position and acceleration will be zero. And what is the maximum velocity formula? A omega. That means according to the given condition, we can take the formula like that. V is equals to root 3 by 2 into V maximum. Okay, V is equals to root 3 by 2 into V maximum. Okay, this is the condition is given to us. V means we can written as omega into under root of A square minus Y square is equals to root 3 by 2 into V maximum is what you can write? A omega. Okay? V maximum is equals to A omega, omega A you can write. What are the terms cancels here? Omega, omega is going to be cancels. Take the square on both sides. If you are taking the square on both sides, it will become A square minus Y square is equals to, it will become 3 by 4 into A square. 3 by 4 into A square. So we have to find out the Y square. So Y square is going to right side and it is coming to this side. So that implies Y square is equals to, it will become A square minus 3A square by 4. That is equals to 1 minus 3 by 4. It is nothing but 1 by 4. 1 by 4 means it will become A square by 4. Y square is equals to A square by 4. Then what is Y is equals to? That implies Y is equals to A by 2. That means half of the amplitude. That means at the displacement of half of the amplitude, what happened? The velocity of the particle will become root 3 by 2 times to the maximum velocity. So which option is correct for this? First option. Okay, A by 2 is the correct option. Okay, let's go for the next problem. Students, welcome back. So in the problem is saying that a simple pendulum is performing the simple harmonic motion with about x is equals to 0. That means no doubt it is starting from the mean position, x is equals to 0 means, and the amplitude is given A and the time period is given T. So the speed of the pendulum at x is equals to A by 2. So at the displacement of A by 2, you have to find out the velocity. Okay. So general formula of the velocity, V is equals to, the formula is omega into root of A square minus x square. Okay, at the place of displacement, either you can use x or you can use the y itself. And what is the x value will be given to us? The x value is given as A by 2. X value is given A by 2. So that implies V is equals to omega into root of A square minus x square means it will become A square by 4. So that is equals to omega into under root of A square minus A square by 4 means it will become 3A square by 4. Okay. But in the options, if you can refer, the omega is also simplified here. If the omega is also simplified here, then what you can write? V is equals to, omega can be written as 2 pi by T into, it will become, A is coming outside and 4 is coming outside. Then it will become A into root 3 by 2. Okay. A is coming outside. A square will become A, 4 is coming out of the root, it will become 2, root 3 will be there, A root 3 by 2. So here 2, 2 is going to be cancelled. That implies V is equals to, what is the formula? It becomes root 3 into pi A by T. This is the velocity at the half of the displacement will be. And which option is correct? First option again, pi into A root 3 by T. Pi into A root 3 by T. Option 1 is correct. Okay, let's go for the next one. Welcome, students. So in the problem, he's saying that he's asking the force, and in the problem, the potential energy is given to you. So there is a relation is there between the force and the potential energy. So the rate of change of energy is nothing but the potential. That means the force F can be written as F is equals to minus du by dx. This formula is very important. Remember this formula. The force F is equals to minus du by dx. And in the problem, the u value is given to you. How much the potential energy is given to you? 8x square is given. 8x square. And what is the x value? Minus 2. The units are given centimeters. Okay, the distance of x is equals to minus 2 centimeters. So you need to find out the force itself. So let us write down that. That implies the force F is equals to d by dx of u. U means what you can write? 8x square. And whatever have negative sign, that is equals to the differentiation of 8x square. X square means x to the power of n dx. X to the power of n means differentiation is n into x to the power of n minus 1. That means it becomes 2 into x to the power of 2 minus 1. That means 8 into 2 into x to the power of 2 minus 1. So that implies the force F is equals to, the negative sign will be there, minus 8 to the 16 into x. But at what displacement is asking? At a displacement of 2 centimeters is asking. And the force is given in which units it is given? Newtons, dynes it is given in. CGS units one it is given. So that's why directly you can substitute the values. So that is equals to, it will become minus of 16 into, at the place of x what you can write? Minus 2. Minus into minus plus. So that implies the force F is equals to 16 to the 32 dynes. Because it is in the CGS units. Okay, this is the formula, and this formula is very important, you must remember. The force is equals to the negative rate of change of the potential energy. F is equals to minus du by dx. Okay, go for next problem. Welcome, students. So in the problem, they are saying that a particle of mass 0.3 kg is given, and the k value is given, force constant. What is that value is given? 15 newton per meter, and the particle is released from 20 centimeters. If the particle is released from 20 centimeters, what does that mean? The 20 centimeters is nothing but amplitude. So the amplitude is also given to you. And what you have to find out? You have to find out what is the initial acceleration you have to find out. So to find out the acceleration, what is the formula? General formula of acceleration, A is equals to omega square A. Okay, the acceleration A is equals to minus omega square A. Negative sign indicates that always the acceleration will work towards the mean position, opposite direction to the displacement. That's why you are going to take the negative sign. Sometimes in the problems, may not need to take the negative sign here. So A is equals to minus omega square A. But there is a formula is there to find out the omega. So omega is equals to under root of m by k. Okay, omega is equals to under root of, it is k by m. Omega is equals to under root of k by m. Here the k is the spring constant and m is the mass. I think in the problem the mass is also given to us. So if I go to substitute this value at here, that implies a is equals to omega square. Omega square means square root will be cancelled. Then you are going to get k by m into amplitude a. And you need to substitute the amplitude in SI units. Okay, go and substitute the values here. That implies the amplitude A is equals to k value, how much it is given? K value is given 15. So it is 15 by 0.3 into A value, how much it is given? 20 centimeters is given. That means it can be written as 20 into 10 to the power of minus 2. 20 into 10 power minus 2. Okay. So go and simplify this equation. That implies A is equals to 15 twos are 30. 30 into 10 is there. That means it will become 300 into 10 to the power of minus 2 by 0.3. For 10 power minus 2, 2 zeros is going to be cancelled out. 0.3, that means 1 by 0.1. If 1 by 0.1, that implies what is the acceleration A is equals to 10. meter per second square. So the acceleration A is equals 10 meter per second square. Which option is correct here? So the fourth option is correct here. Okay, 10 meter per second square. You need to remember this formula. Omega is equals to root of k by m. This is a general formula you can use in the case of simple harmonic motion, or you can use in the case of springs, or you can use in the case of the time period of the simple pendulum also. Okay, omega is equals to root of k by m. Okay, go for the next problem. So in the problem, there is a time period is given to you. It is given 8 seconds, and x t is equals to 0, it is at the mean position. That means no doubt the simple harmonic motion is starting from the mean position, and you have to find out the ratio of the distances covered in first second and the second second. So the distance, the ratio of the distances traveled in first second and the second second, and at time t is equal to 0, it is starting from the mean position. Whenever it is starting from the mean position, what is the general equation will be? Y is equals to A sine omega t. Okay, if it is starting from the mean position, then Y is equals to A sine omega t. And in the problem, the time period is given to you. Capital T is equals to how much is given? 8 seconds it is given. So you have to find out first what is the distance traveled in 1 second and what is the distance traveled in 2 seconds. But we don't need the distance traveled in 2 seconds. We need the distance traveled in second second. How can you find out the distance traveled in the second second? The distance traveled in the second second is equals to y2 minus y1. Okay, if you do y2 minus y1, what happens? Only you are going to get how much distance it is traveled in the second second only. So first we have to find out y1, then we have to find out y2, and what is the ratio will be? Y1 by y2 minus y1. That will give you the ratio itself. So let us write down first y1 is equals to, it is a sine. Okay, omega means what we can write? 2 pi by t into small t. Okay, 2 pi by t into small t. Because at the time of 1, what you have to take? 1 second you have to take. That means at the place of t, 1 second you have to take. So that implies y1 is equals to, it will becomes a into sine 2 pi by t. T how much you are taking? 8 into t is equals to how much you have to take? 1. So t by 2 pi by 8. 2 pi by 8 means it is nothing but pi by 4. So sine pi by 4 is nothing but 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2 means this is equals to a by root 2, you can call it as the equation of 1. Okay, we have calculated what is the distance traveled in the first second. Next, we have to find out the distance traveled in the 2 seconds. So the distance traveled in 2 seconds, y2 is equals to the same formula I can use, a sine omega, omega means what you can write, 2 pi by t means what you can write, 8 into, at the place of t, how much you have to write, 2 seconds. You have to write 2 seconds. So then what happens, a into sine. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, that means sine pi by 2. Sine pi by 2 means, what is the sine pi by 2 value will be equals to 1. If sine pi by 2 is equals to 1, then what is this value will be equals to a. You can call it as the equation number 2. So, this is the distance traveled in 1 second, and this is the distance traveled in 2 seconds. But we need to find out the distance traveled in second second. That means what I have to do, y2 minus y1. So, that implies this equation will be the ratio of y1 by y2 minus y1. Okay, the ratio of distance traveled in the first second to the distance traveled in the second second. That is equals to y1. Y1 means how much you can write? A by root 2 by y2. Y2 means what you can write? A minus y1 means what you can write? A by root 2. That is equals to, let us simplify this. It will becomes A by root 2 by, A will be taken as common, 1 minus 1 by root 2. 1 minus 1 by root 2 means it will becomes A into, okay, A into, it will become root 2 minus 1 by root 2. Root 2 minus 1 by root 2. Okay. So what is going to be cancelled here? A is going to be cancelled. Okay, numerator. And root 2 is going to be cancelled. So that implies the ratio will be equals to 1 by root 2 minus 1. Okay, 1 by root 2 minus 1. So this is the ratio of the distance traveled in the first second and the distance traveled in the second second. So if you go to refer to the options, the third option is correct, 1 by root 2 minus 1. Okay, remember the process. Okay, distance traveled in the second second means directly you should not take y2. Okay, y2 is distance traveled in 2 seconds, not in second second. So if one find out the distance traveled in second means the distance traveled in 2 seconds minus the distance traveled in 1 second. Then you are going to get the distance traveled in the second. Okay, this is the answer. Let's go for the next problem. Hello students, welcome back again. So in the problem, he is saying that the two particles are there, P1 and P2 are performing the SHM and both are at the two positive extreme positions. Two positive extreme positions means no doubt the displacement what I have to take, cos theta you have to take. Okay, y is equals to a cos omega t. And in the problem, he is saying that the distance between the time period is given to you, 12 seconds, and the difference in their amplitudes is given 12 centimeters. So find the minimum time after at which the both are going to be separated by 6 centimeters. That means both are separated by 6 centimeters. What does that mean? Y2 minus Y1 or Y1 minus Y2 you have to find out. So when you are going to find out Y2 minus Y1, then immediately what happened? That will give you the difference between them and that value is given 6 centimeters. Let us write down the equations first. No doubt both are in the extreme positions. So the equation, the simple harmonic equation will be in the form of cos function. So let us write down here y1 is equals to a cos omega t. Okay, the amplitudes are different here, he is saying. Let us say that y1 is equals to a1 cos omega t. Omega t will be remain same amplitude. And what about y2 is equals to a2 cos omega t. y2 is equals to a2 cos omega t. Find out the difference between them. Difference between them means you can find out y1 minus y2 is equals to. Y1 minus Y2 is equal to means cos omega t will be taken as common. Then what you are going to get? A1 minus A2 you are going to get. That means it will be written as A1 minus A2 into, it can be written as cos omega t. Okay, cos omega t. Okay, go on, simplify this equation. This is Y1 minus Y2 is equal to, the difference between the amplitudes is given to you. What is the difference between the amplitudes is given? Difference between the amplitudes is given 12 centimeters. So all the values are there in the centimeters only, directly substitute in centimeters. So this value you can written as 12 centimeters into cos. Omega means what you can write 2 pi by t into small t. And this small t value you have to find out. So to find out that y1 minus y2 is also given to us. What is the y1 minus y2 is given? When the both the particles are separated by how much distance? 6 centimeters distance is given. So 6 centimeters distance means this y1 minus y2 is equal to how much you have to take? 6. Is equals to 12 into cos, it will be 2 pi by t. What is the time period is given to you? Time period is given again 12 seconds it is given. So it is given 12 seconds into time t. Okay. So what is going to cancel here? It will be 2 sigs r, it will be takes place and 12 is coming to this side. So what happens here? Cos, it will be pi by 6 into t is equals to 6 by 12 is nothing but 1 by 2. So it is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 means what does that mean? It should be equals to cos 60. Cos 60 means what you can write? Pi by 3. That implies what you can write? Pi by 6 into t is equals to, and this value you can written as cos pi by 3. Okay? Pi by t 6 is equals to pi by 3. You can written as pi by 3 you are writing. And when you are going to simplify it, pi is going to be cancelled. That implies t is equals to, it will become 6 by 3, that is equals to 2 seconds. Okay, so which option is correct here? First option is correct here. Okay, so simply what you are doing here, find out the difference between them, and the difference between the amplitudes is given and the time period is given to you. Simplify it at the place of 1 by 2, you can write down cos pi by 3, and finally the time t is equals to 2 seconds. That means after 2 seconds, both the particles are separated by how much distance? 6 centimeters distance itself. Okay, let's go for the next problem. Welcome, students. So in the problem, there is a graph is given to you, and the particle is starting from the mean position, and it is going to be oscillating based on the force they are going to be applied. So the graph will be given to you like this. This is the graph is given on the x-axis and on the y-axis. So it is the point you are taking +2, and here you are taking -2. Okay, you are taking here -2. You are taking, and this is +2. And what is the is given force is given, this is 8, and this is -8 newtons are given, and it is going to be oscillating from the mean position. Okay, it is oscillating in the mean position, and it is traveling in this direction, positive direction it will be there. So the graph will clearly explain that how much force is applied here. 8 newtons of force is applied, and at the place of time displacement, how much it is there? 2 centimeters is there, because the units are given in meters. So directly can take 2 meters, and 8 newtons is given. So time period is asking. To find out the time period, what is the formula? The time period T is equal to, you can use 2 pi into under root of m by k. Okay, because T is equal to 2 pi by omega. Omega means under root of k by m. If you want to write down reverse, it will become m by k. So here the mass, it is already given in the problem. How much mass is given? 0.01 kg. But we don't have the k value. We have to find out this k value. So let us say that this is the equation number 1. To find out the k value, we can use the force constant formula. The force F is equal to k into x. Negative sign indicates both are in opposite direction. The force and the displacement are in opposite direction. That implies what I can write, k is equal to F by x. Okay, k is equal to what I can write, F by x. That means you can recognize that implies k is equal to F, how much you take? 8 by x. Displacement, how much you take? 2. That is equal to 8 by 2, that is nothing but 4. And what are the units of K? Force by distance, that means newton per meter, 4 newton per meter. So this is the K value we are calculated. Once you have calculated the K value, then it is very easy to find out the time period. What is the time period formula? T is equal to 2 pi into root of m by K. So let us say that this is the second equation. Substitute the second equation in the first equation. From the first and the second equations, the time period T is equal to 2 pi into under root of mass. How much mass is given here? 0.01 kg. Okay, 0.01 kg. 0.01 by k value, how much I calculated? 4. Okay, go on, simplify this equation. That is equal to 2 into pi value, what you can write? 3.14 into 0.01 is coming out of the root, it will become 0.1. Because 0.1 into 0.1, 0.01. So it will become 0.1 by 4 is coming out of the root, it will become 2. So what is going to be cancelled here? 2 is going to be cancelled here. Then whenever you calculate 3.14 into 0.1, it will become 0.314. So that means that implies the time period T is equal to 0.31. Okay, 0.31, it will be in seconds. Okay, which option is correct here? When you refer to the options, it is given 0.30, so it is the nearest value, because if you are going to simplify the pi value, 3.14, so 0.31, it is very nearer to that, so option D is correct. Okay, 0.31 seconds. Okay, so that's all for today. Tomorrow we are going to solve some more problems based on these oscillations. Okay, thank you.